Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Zheng Yutong East Asian Library. My name is Stephen Chow. I'm acting director of this library. Today is our special session for our magnificent Chinese Civilization Lecture Series. We are delighted to invite Master Tam Shek Wing here to give us a talk today. And the topic of his talk is Zen of Emptiness and Existence, Buddhist Thinking on Cause and Effect, and the Modern Society. The topic in Chinese is Chan Yu Yu De, Kong Yu Yu De Chan Fa, Fu Jia Yuan Qi Si Xiang, Yu Dang Dai She Hui. Master Tam is from Nanhai, Guangdong, China. He is a student of His Holiness Dudajom Rinpoche, the late leader of Nyingma school of Buddhism in Tibet. He has studied and practiced Buddhism for over 40 years, during which he has write, translate, and edit over 70 books on Buddhism. He is also a painter, poet, writer, and social critic. He donated some of his books and one painting to the East Asian Library to show his support of this library. Later on, you can see the paintings on the other side of the wall over here. In 2008, Mr. Tam was invited as a guest lecturer at Renmin University in China. In the process, he established the Center for Sino-Tibetan Buddhism Studies. He became their visiting professor and the chief academic consultant for the monograph series of Sino-Tibetan Buddhism Studies. By invitation of Zhejiang University, Sun Yat-sen University, and other universities in China, he also gave a guest lectures of Tathagatagarbha and the related system of training. Today's lecture is Master Tam's first lecture in the University of Toronto. He will speak on the impact of human behavior and thinking on the world at large. Based upon the Tathagatagarbha doctrine, he will introduce Buddhist concepts of a fourfold, dependent, arising, and non-duality. These ideas will be illustrated through a variety of interesting current events in politics and economics as bridges to the teaching and their application in everyday life. The lecture is going to be delivered in Mandarin Chinese, Master Tam already mentioned earlier, with English translation. At the end of this lecture, you will have a chance to ask questions. The light refreshment is prepared by this library in a small reception after that. Before Dr. Master Tam's lecture, I also would like to announce that we have another lecture next week. The topic of that lecture will be the Chinese Canadians' identity and activism, and the talk by the Brand Li and Lian Chen. So if you are interested in that topic, you welcome back for that lecture. Thank you. Now, without further delay, let's invite Master Tam to give us a speech.
Now let's open the lecture.
So we will start.
Okay. 讲到佛家，一般都是看到佛家讲的空性。
So typically, when you talk about, most people think about Buddhism is mostly about emptiness.
可是怎么样叫做空呢？ 怎么样叫做空性呢？ 就有很多在佛家里边，就有很多不同的说法了。
what exactly it means by emptiness in Buddhism. Within Buddhist different sects, there are many different thinkings and sayings.
今天我讲的就是用于来讲来讲佛家的空性。
So today I will focus on the Tathagatagarbha doctrine to talk about emptiness. So this is that particular term about the Tathagatagarbha.
如果懂得于来讲思想的人就晓得只有用于来讲这样来讲空才是究竟的，其他的讲法是不究竟，只是能够作为一个理解空性的基础。
So if you do not know anything about the Tathagatagarbha doctrine, other ways of thinking cannot be treated as the ultimate thinking about emptiness. They can only be treated as some sort of basis or foundation as a step to promote you to understanding, have a more proper understanding of emptiness.
佛家讲空，都说跟缘起有关。
So this particular term is dependent arising. In some translation, it is cause and effect. So whenever the Buddhas talk about emptiness, the basis for talking about it, it's also always about cause and effect or dependent arising.
有一个很大的误解，就是说如来藏思想跟缘起是没有关系的。
So there's a major misunderstanding out there that thinking about Tathagatagarbha, sorry, it's a mouthful, is unrelated to dependent arising or cause and effect.
因此在日本就有人说缘起与这个如来藏思想是冲突的，所以因此如来藏思想是不对的。
So in fact, there are some scholars in Japan who think that Tathagatagarbha, actually I'm going to shorten it to call it Buddha nature anyway. So Buddha nature is in conflict with dependent arising or cause and effect.
其实他们这样的理解是完全不对的，所以我现在今天讲的这是澄清解释问题，让我们理解空性与如来藏思想的关系。
So here, Master Tam is trying to clarify some of the thinking about emptiness, the doctrine on Buddha nature and dependent arising.
如来藏到底是什么样的？怎么样叫做如来藏呢？现在其实理解这个人不多，他们只是从看经，然后自己猜如来藏应该是怎样的。
So what exactly is about Buddha nature or the Buddha within? So most people tend to approach this from the surface meaning of words in sutras and different scriptures, and they guess what the meaning what it exactly is about, but not very many people know what it's about.
根据他们这样的猜想，如来藏思想就有很多问题了。
So based on their guesses, lots of problems arise from their guesses.
为什么会发生这个问题呢？主要的原因就是佛讲经是用言说来讲的，可是这个言说并不能代表佛真实的意思，因为所有言说之外还有一个叫密意。
So these sort of problems or misunderstanding a lot of the time has the basis from Buddha. Buddha has to actually make use of language to describe describe Buddhism. And when you actually look into the wording, there's always that meaning, a deeper meaning behind. Some we call it the secret meaning. In fact, really, what he's intended to express.
为什么佛只能用这个密意来讲？如来藏就跟什么叫如来藏有关了。
So what exactly by what we mean by secret meaning is really depend on your or on our understanding on Buddha nature of the Buddha within.
如来藏，如果现在我们用很简单的语言来表达它，就可以这样说。
So about Buddha nature or Buddha within, we can use simpler language to explain what that is.
Just like that. 佛成佛，什么人成佛，都要证一个字才能成佛。用什么去证这个字呢？用觉，用觉去证这个字。
In order to attain Buddhahood, you have to attain the wisdom. And how can you attain the wisdom? It's the awareness.
当证了智之后，我们就可以说它有一种等于说心理状态的。不过对于佛来讲，我们就不讲它是心理状态，我们就说是智的境界。
So when you actually attain this kind of realization, there you have, we don't refer to this as a psychological state, and yet it is a psychological state. And here we refer to it as a the realm, the wisdom realm.
那么解个自境有一个专有名词叫佛赖自证自境，是强调佛赖就是不得离因了。
we have to take turns of it. There is a special Buddhist term to describe this realm of wisdom, and from what we can read from the Buddhist scriptures, it is known as the personal realization, the inner state of realization of Buddhahood.
这个佛赖自证的境界是我们不能理解的，因为是佛的自境，佛的自境就超越了世间，因此我们住在世间的人就没法子了解他的境界，不能用语言去形容他，也想他不出来，我们就把这叫做不可思议了。
This realm of realization is not something that we can properly understand because it goes beyond our mundane realm of experience. Okay, so because of this, in the Buddhist scripture, it is usually described as inconceivable.
这样一个境界，我们又另外又给一个名词给它，就叫做如来法身。当讲法身的时候，我们不要以为身这个字让我们想到它是一个个体，其实不是的，一个法身只是一个境界。
There is yet another way to describe it, about this realm of wisdom, and it is usually known as the Dharmakaya in Sanskrit. And the word Dharmakaya means the body of truth, the body of reality. But having called this a body of reality might mislead us to understand that it is an entity of some sort. But it is indeed not any sort of entity. And it's not an object for even worship.
Beyond form.
It's beyond form, it's formless, it is said to pervade everything and so forth. And this word Dharmakaya, or the body of truth, is merely yet another description of this realm of wisdom.
那首先我们要记住法身只是一个境界，不是一个个体。
So this Dharma body, or the body of truth, is nothing but a state of wisdom, a realm of wisdom.
那么这个境界跟我们有没有关系呢？有很大的关系。
And how is this state of wisdom related to us? Well, having said that, it's a realization of the Buddha. How is it related to ourselves? And Master Tam said that there is very intricate in a kind of relationship.
我们的世界可以称为与佛的自境相对，我们可以说是自境，实境。实就是我们那个心思，我们心思的功能就是用来分别东西。就是我们一个分别的境界，心思的境界，就是我们那个世间。
The world that we know, the realm that we experience, is said to be relative, or even opposite to the state of the Buddha. And we call this the realm of consciousness. Okay? So it's a consciousness realm. It's a realm based on language, conceptualities, and so forth.